गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिविक्स, दैट इज द जुडिशरी. क्लोज. सो अंडर दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट द जुडिशरी. एज यू नो दैट गवर्नमेंट हैज थ्री ऑर्गन. फर्स्ट इज लेजिस्लेचर, एग्जीक्यूटिव एंड द थर्ड वन इज जुडिशरी. एज लेजिस्लेचर मेक लॉ एंड टू कैरी आउट दैट लॉ द वर्क ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटिव इज दैट. So after that the last organ is, that is judiciary, to check that all the law which were given was functioning properly or not. That is a work of judiciary. Because in this chapter we will learn about the judicial system which is provided by the constitution of India. Clear? So under this we will learn about the courts as under the judicial system. At the apex means top, under one pyramid is there. So on the top of this pyramid, who work? Supreme court do all the functions. Okay, after that high courts are there of each state or related to states, and after that subordinate court perform the function. So one pyramid is made by the constitution of India, that at the apex of the this pyramid supreme court perform function. After supreme court, below that high courts are there, and below high courts subordinate courts available. Clear? Which providers justice, or we can go to the court if any we face any kind of problem. If any kind of case is there, then we move to the court for the judgment. So which type of cases brought to them under this court? So that case is also categorized into two parts. So cases, two type of cases are there. One is criminal cases, and another one is civil cases. So two type of cases are there, criminal cases and civil cases. Under the criminal cases, the cases related to robbery, डकैतीज, मर्डर, ऑल दीज टाइप ऑफ केसेज कम अंडर द क्रिमिनल कैटेगरी. एंड अंडर द सिविल केसेज वी कैन से दैट केसेज रिलेटेड टू फैमिली मैटर्स लाइक डायवोर्स, देन माइनर डिस्प्यूट बिटवीन फैमिली मेंबर्स, और डिस्प्यूट्स रिलेटेड टू कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स, डैमेज ऑफ गुड्स, लाइक दैट टाइप, सच टाइप ऑफ केसेज विच इज रिलेटेड टू फैमिली मैटर ओनली, दैट्स कम अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ सिविल केसेज. सो टू टाइप ऑफ केसेज वी कैन ब्राउट टू द डिफरेंट कोर्ट्स. वन इज क्रिमिनल, अनदर the one is civil cases. Clear? Now first we will talk about the Supreme Court, which is on the top. After the decision of Supreme Court, no one can raise their voice. Clear? So first is the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court as we already told you that it was on the top. Clear? Top, it set up in the country on top, and it consisted one chief justice and not more than other 33 judges. Clear? So Supreme Court consists one chief justice and not more than other 33 judges. So chief justice, who is the present chief justice of Supreme Court? That is Sharad Arvind. So Supreme Court, under the Supreme Court, different judges appointed by the President of India. As we learn in the previous chapter, that is the power of President to appoint the judges of Supreme Court and High Court. So here is a composition, how the chief justice and other judges appointed, who will appoint them. So first we will talk about the chief justice of that Supreme Court. Who appointed this? Only the President. So President of India appoint the chief justice of India. Other justices appointed by the consultation with the chief justice and President. So other judges appointed by the suggestion, by the consultation of chief justice by President. So President consult with the chief justice while appointing the other 33 judges of Supreme Court. Clear? That is the composition of Supreme Court judges. Understood? So next we will talk about the term, how long the judges of Supreme Court perform their duties. So one year not mentioned, only the age limit is given to the court judges, that 65 year of age. 65 years of age. Till that age, judges of the Supreme Court can perform their duties, perform their function. But if they are only one process is there, that is impeachment. Means the majority of Parliament House member, if pass one resolution against any judge, if he is not doing his work properly, if he found violated the constitution, or if he prove misbehavior, if he prove incapable during that time, majority of vote passed by the Parliament member, both members, during that time through the process of impeachment, only the judges of a Supreme Court can remove from his office by the President. Otherwise, till 65 year of age limit is given to perform their duties. Clear? So, I think this one is clear. Composition, under the composition, President appoint Chief Justice and other 33 judges he appoint with the consultation of Chief Justice, and 65 year is a age limit to perform the duties. Now, qualifications. What is required to become the judge of a Supreme Court? So qualifications are there. First, the most prior importance given to the citizen of India means he must be a citizen of India. So first is citizen of India. Next, that is given that he should have been high court judge for at least 10 years. High court judge, how many years? 10 year. At least 10 year experience needed in high court judge if a person want to become the judge of a Supreme Court. Clear? Or third qualification is necessary, he should have been an advocate. If he is not a judge of a high court, then advocate, or advocate of a high court, at least 10 year, same period is there. So 10 year is necessary, advocate of high court. So advocate of high court as well as judge of high court can become the judge of Supreme Court, but 10 year experience is needed, as well as a person must be a citizen of India. So that is a qualification required to become a judge of Supreme Court. Clear? Now, powers of the Supreme Court. Next is powers. Powers of the Supreme Court. Supreme Court is the head judicial hierarchy. Hierarchy means a system of member of an organization which rank on top. So as we tell that Supreme Court is on apex, its rank is high. So that function, that power is given by the Constitution to the Supreme Court. So under the functions, under the powers, it was categorized into different, like judicial function. First we will talk about the judicial functions, judicial power. Which type of function can perform and which type of cases can brought to the Supreme Court under the judicial function. So under the judicial function, one is original jurisdiction and one is appellate jurisdiction. Original and appellate jurisdiction. So under the jurisdiction, some of the judges were appointed under the jurist, and some cases brought to cases were categorized which come under the jurisdictional, and some cases come under the appellate jurisdiction which brought to the Supreme Court for hearing. So which type of cases come under the original jurisdiction, that we will discuss first. So like dispute between the center and state government. So any dispute related to state or center government that directly brought to the Supreme Court under the original jurisdiction, means directly that type of case, if any dispute was there between state government and central government regarding any issue, that such type of cases directly move to the Supreme Court under the original jurisdiction. And under the original jurisdiction, Supreme Court has a authority to hear cases for the first instance. Means first instance by priority, that's such type of cases handled by the Supreme Court under the original jurisdiction. Clear? So second category is a dispute between two states. Clear? Two states. So if any state regarding the any two states relation was not good, any issues regarding there, if any issue related to river, related to electricity was going on between two states, such type of issues was also directly moved to the Supreme Court under the original jurisdiction. Clear? So one can also move to Supreme Court in cases of infringement of a fundamental right. Fundamental right. Clear? So three are there under the original jurisdiction. I'm going to rub this one so it will visible to you. Under the original jurisdiction, state and central government, any dispute regarding any issue, if there between state and center, directly move to the Supreme Court under original. Then dispute between two states regarding any issue, regarding river matter, regarding water, regarding electricity, that move brought to the Supreme Court for hearing under the original jurisdiction. And and fundamental right, if any person's fundamental right infringement is violated by anyone, then that person also can move to the Supreme Court directly for the hearing of such type of cases. Clear? So these three type of cases can brought to Supreme Court under the original jurisdiction. Clear? Now we will talk about the appellate jurisdiction. Appellate jurisdiction. Under the appellate jurisdiction, the Supreme Court can hear only such type of cases which can go on through by the other court, by the Supreme Court, by the High Court or by the subordinate court. If any case which was already discussed in High Court or subordinate, but the decision is not related to the cases, means if a person is not satisfied with High Court or Supreme Court, then with the special reference to that court only, that case brought to Supreme Court under the appellate jurisdiction. Directly not moved to Supreme Court, but by the special reference given by the High Court, that case can brought to Supreme Court for second hearing. Clear? So in such type of cases also criminal and civil, both type of cases come under the appellate jurisdiction, civil as well as criminal. Both type of cases can move to Supreme Court by the special reference given by the High Court or subordinate court. Clear? So an appeal can also be made to Supreme Court if the High Court concern has certified that such a question is not involved. Clear? So under the appellate jurisdiction, civil and criminal, both type of cases can move to Supreme Court. And under the original jurisdiction, direct cases can brought to Supreme Court. Already you know that disputes related to different state or different center state, like that, can brought to the court. Now we will talk about the administrative function. Judicial function over. Next is administrative function. Administrative functions. So under the administrative functions, first is advisory function. Clear? Advisory functions means president can seek the opinion of Supreme Court opinion. Clear? Regarding which issue? Regarding the law. If any bill was passed by the parliament members, parliament, if any bill was passed, then president can seek the opinion of Supreme Court. But in such type of case, Supreme Court is not bound to give its opinion to the president, and president is also not bound to accept the decision which is given by the Supreme Court. Clear? So such type of case is called the advisory functions. Clear? So under the advisory functions, what is there? President can seek opinion of Supreme Court, but Supreme Court is not bound to give decision or give suggestion, and president is also not bound to take that suggestion. Clear? They both are free. Now next is court of record. court of record. Supreme Court is also known as court of record, means all the cases which are come to the Supreme Court, all the hearings, all the cases report can be kept in record in printed form. Clear? So what is there in printed form? Records kept. Records kept. Why they kept the records in for that? Just for the future references, so that they can use such type of cases for, they can take the reference of cases in future, as well as for the use of the lawyer in their pleading. So that is the main purpose of the court of record, means they kept material in printed form, all the cases decision in records. Next is judicial review. Judicial review. Under the judicial review, the Supreme Court uphold the supremacy and sanctity of the Constitution. The Supreme Court declare a law null. Okay, Supreme Court has a power to declare any law null if Parliament passes a law which is in the violation of the Constitution. Means if law is passed by the Parliament member and that law violated the Constitution rule, then the judicial review can be given by the Supreme Court regarding such type of cases. Now, guardian of fundamental right. As already we told you that if fundamental right of any person is violated, then that is a power given to the person, that right given to the person, that person, particular person can move to high court for the protection, for the safeguard of fundamental right. So it is, it also function like a guardian of a fundamental right, guardian. And regarding this, Supreme Court can issue writ regarding the safeguard of fundamental right of our Indian citizens. Clear? Writ we will do after. Then High Court. Next, Supreme Court is clear. Under the Supreme Court, what we learned about the qualification required, then composition, and after that powers.